then give the oral solution might be.
Okay. Now what you are doing here is, then you are becoming a doctor.
Okay.
Then you are becoming a doctor. In some cases, like technical problems, root cause kind of problem, that may be good, but that is what we are learning here. We are learning something like, we say, okay, you have a problem? Okay, let me talk to you so that you can find your own solution without I understand your problem. Example, so there is a CEO who runs a company and there are many departments. There is a sales, marketing, HR, development, and all those departments. Now, development head is thinking, you know, I should go to machine learning, but I am unable to decide which platform, which tools I should start with. Let's go and ask CEO. Probably, it will happen.
Yeah.
Similarly, the sales guy is thinking, I am doing everything, sales is not happening. Let's go and ask CEO. Doesn't it like it? CEO is there.
Yes, CEO is.
Finally, they will go to him.
Yes.
Now, what CEO is expected to do here? CEO will say, okay, send me the machine learning manual, send me all the options, I will study and tell you what should you do. If he do, then he should be a department head for that development department.
Yes.
And if he also makes a marketing strategy or sales strategy, then he should be a department for sales, not for CEO. Now what he do?
He'll connect you to the right person.
So if I am connecting you to the right person, it means I already believe this guy is useless. I need to get some help from him.
Ask questions from there.
So idea is, I need to believe that in our company, he's the best guy who can think about it. Okay? Now if he says ultimately himself, that I need an assistance, can you hire a third party agency? That is a separate case. But if I am saying go to that guy, it means I am already saying this guy is useless, go to that guy.
Mm.
And then what he will do, he will always go to that guy. And then he is really becoming useless. So what CEO can do here is, and you can also see in your context as Scrum and all those things, I need to first trust that, okay, he knows far, far better than me, so I don't have to be an expert with him, but he's unable to think through. So let me give him some questions so that his clutter gets cleaned up and he can find out what should you do next. He says, okay, what makes you worried about it? What are the options you are alternating? What are the risks associated with those alternatives? What in your view you should do? Okay, when you have this idea, what are the possible things can go wrong? Is there anything somebody can do to make you comfortable about these options? That's it. Now, these are the questions which I can ask without knowing anything about the subject. And the similar kind of work I have to do with the sales guy. And that's what we are learning here. So we are exploring those kind of questions. Now, I am not denying that in some cases, you may play an expert. Okay, where you are expected to be a doctor. So we are keeping those things aside. We are taking up the areas where you are expected to solve people's thinking problem, not by prescribing, but helping them to think through.
It's a kind of way of what you're doing, that you're trying to structure his way of thinking.
Structure way of thinking, make him think.
Make him think of the alternatives and different options, right?
That's it.
That maybe he's not able to get those options.
So it's a skill
quickly
of listening, asking, and making the other person's thoughts clear to him only.
Basically thinking about all the aspects of that particular thing.
Making him think about all the aspects of that particular. So in a simple way, the coaching conversation, not only powerful questioning, coaching conversation usually gets structured in three areas. First, you spend time, you ask the questions which helps the person find out what he really wants to do. So you spend time in identifying the goals. So you ask initial set of questions to find out actually what do you need. Because whatever is coming out, like for example, I say I want to wake up at 5:30. So maybe you spend time in identifying it. What do you want to do in the morning? What are your goals? Wake up at a 5:30 can't be a goal. It's a solution for something.
Motivation.
So what do you want to do? So you spend time in identifying, okay, I want to do A, B, C in the morning. And for that, I am thinking if I wake up at a 5:30, I should be able to do it. So initial set of questions are more about identifying the need. Usually people come up with asking you a solution for a solution which they have in mind. But they rarely discuss the problem and goal with you. I want to wake up at 5:30. It means I already have something in my head and I have already figured it out. If I wake up at 5:30, this something will get solved. And now I am going to ask you, can you make me do that? And it may happen, even if I wake up at 5:30, that something is still not solved. So the initial set of coaching skill is to find out what do you need, okay? And we can set up about the goals. Now once the need is settled down, then you make the person think about ways to achieve that need. That okay, I want to achieve this, now these are the possible ways. You talk about all the risks, challenge all those ways, and finally you take the conversation towards what would you like to do next week? It's great, you spoke to me half an hour, but now what are you going to do about it? Rather than just having a good conversation. So the third section in a coaching conversation moves towards finding out some actionable things. Then okay, this, and I want to do this. Now actionable things does not necessarily always solve the need. It could be more investigation about the need. Maybe the problem is so complex that in a half an hour conversation, the person won't be able to find out what should be their machine learning strategy for the organization. But he may find out that what he should do to reach to a stage so that he can identify a machine learning strategy. So he may talk about that, okay, I will join some trade conference, I will write email to someone, or I will meet some consultants, or I will do something. The person finds out the path to it. So there has to be some action. And this is how we usually organize the coaching conversations. Does it make sense?